unfortunately, we can't repeat them all. But I did make a couple of notes. And just to get started, I guess, with some background, could you tell us like where you were born and raised?
I was born in Des Moines, Iowa. Lived there till I was about six. My family, much like the movie, although my parents, because I was six then, decided that California was calling. It was in that time. It was a major move, and it was something that a lot of people did to kind of get away from the old and get to the new, and so on. So I was moved out there when I was six, and didn't leave until I was about 21.
Yeah, I love reading his biography. It talked about how he got started in plays because his father was a frustrated actor, and he appeared in this play and that play, and then he started first grade. And when they moved to California, you got involved with the Pasadena Playhouse.
Yeah, the Pasadena Playhouse was an amateur theater, but many stars, many people started there, and it was a place where aspiring actors, actresses would come and do plays. And the production values were very high, and the attendance was very high. So it was a great place to get started. And I was very fortunate to have gotten a role in a Christmas play. Christmas seems to play a big role in all of our lives, and certainly mine. An agent saw me there in the play, and talked to my parents and said she'd like to represent me and so on. And of course they were all very thrilled, and I guess I was thrilled too. I was about six then. It turned out that she was an agent that handled about 500 or 600 child actors. And her name was Lola Moore, I'll never forget that name. And she would send 25 or 30 of her kids out on interviews at a time. And so it was sort of almost, I came to find out later, that it was sort of a joke around Hollywood. Oh, you're a Lola Moore person. But I got the role in the Come to the Stable, the Loretta Young movie that was in the clip. The next role was a non-speaking role in Holiday Affair. I played Joey. I was cast to play Joey, and I played Joey for about 2 days. And the director called my parents in and said, "Who's your agent?" And they said, "Well, Lola Moore." I said, "Well, we would like Gordon to play the leading role because the boy who cast and we already shot for about 10 days is not working out." So they started the movie all over again with me in the role. And if you look in the databases that describe movies, a boy named, I think it's Johnny Wright, is actually listed as the kid that was cast in the movie. There's still a record of that.
I love that. His second movie you saw a ton of. Janet Leigh said he was a natural talent, even though his hair went in every direction and he liked to play games on the set. Before we see all these films, I always try to read everything I can to get a couple of good stories. And one of the Janet Leigh stories was when they're sitting down at the table, it's kind of uncomfortable. She's got her fiancé on one side and the man who's in love with her on the other side. Well, these consummate actors knew that if she was a little more uncomfortable, it would photograph well. So under the table, they reached over to her leg. And they would slide their hands carefully up her leg while the camera was running, and she was told to just play the scene, not knowing they were going to be doing that. So when she looked uncomfortable, she was.
Well, I wasn't aware of that.
You were at the other end of the table, of course.
But, you know, it's interesting because Don Hartman was the producer and director. And there was a screenwriter, Imogene Leonard, who did a number of screenplays, including some of the Bob Hope movies and Funny Girl and so on. But he it was really written by two other groups, really. One is that he rewrote a lot of the movie. And I think, I'm told that the short story, which I actually never read, was not a comedy. There's very little or no humor in it at all. He turned the movie into a bit of a comedy, to a sort of a light comedy. And a lot of that business that you saw that got little laughs here tonight and got many laughs in the theaters when it showed, were really injected either by him or by the cast. There was a lot of improvisation and a lot of ad-libbing that went on. And I credit certainly the actors, Robert Mitchum, Jenna Leigh, Wendell Corey. They really work well together, as I recall, on the set. And your story kind of parallels that. But they also, there was a lot of kibitzing, which was a word out of the movie. There was a lot of kibitzing, there was a lot of improv, a lot of ad-libbing. And I credit Don Hartman for that mostly, because he really worked with the actors and let them run with it. And he would pick up that chemistry, he would pick up the lines, he would pick up the business. And it's interesting, yeah, this is the first time I've seen the film since probably 1949 or 50 on the big screen. I've seen it a lot on, you know, the smaller screens and even the bigger screen, although not recently, actually. But to see it on the big screen again after so many years is really a fantastic, wonderful experience. And I really want to thank Jenny and you, Larry, for inviting me down and getting a chance to see it. It's a great experience.
I loved when we were talking earlier this evening, you started telling stories about Don Hartman, about the producer who really hired people to get the film made and directed it and rewrote the script. It was really his project, and the sad truth is, historically, we have found out that the film lost money. He ended up getting fired, and he went to television, and it kind of ended his cinema career. But you guys get to reevaluate whether the film was worth it or not. And we think it was.